U.S. Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump weighs in on allegations that his campaign was hacked. The former president said on Saturday they were informed by Microsoft that Iran hacked one of their websites. The FBI has launched an investigation into the allegation, which the Iranian government has denied.
They're looking at it, and they're doing it very professionally, and it looks like it's Iran doing it, because Iran is no friend of mine, and, you know, a lot of bad signals get sent, but it looks like it's Iran doing it, and the reason is because I was strong on Iran, and I was protecting people in the Middle East that maybe they aren't so happy about that. So that's what it seems to be, Iran.
Is that what the FBI told you specifically, that it was Iran?
I don't want to say exactly, but it was Iran.
The FBI is also investigating an alleged hack targeting campaign advisors on the Democratic side before U.S. President Joe Biden dropped out of the race. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, rather, T.J. Manotok.
Good morning to friends of The Rundown. I'm T.J. Manotok with your headlines from the North American region.
We begin with developments on the war in Ukraine. U.S. President Joe Biden calls Kiev's military incursion into Russia a real dilemma for Russian leader Vladimir Putin. His comments follow the August 6 attack by Ukraine into Russia's Kursk region that caught Moscow by surprise. Biden says U.S. officials have since been in constant communication with their counterparts in Kiev. He also shares receiving regular updates on the operations in the past week. Washington has provided billions of dollars of weapons to Ukraine to repel Moscow's 2022 assault on Kiev. Next to California, as Los Angeles rolled out the massive pink carpet and welcomed some of the most iconic, charismatic, and beloved drag queens as hundreds of Ru girls and their fans partied for RuPaul's DragCon Los Angeles. Among the queens turning heads at DragCon LA, Drag Race Philippines Season 1 runner-up and UK versus the World contestant and current Tarsier artist Marina Summers, who is in the midst of a world tour.
It's my second time in DragCon LA, and we're not stopping anytime soon. I will be here every single year because I love LA. I love the fans here when they come to RuPaul's DragCon. And just to represent, you know, Filipino drag here is amazing with my fellow Filipino sisters.
There's no slowing down the Pinay pride in RuPaul's world. Season 3 of Drag Race Philippines has just launched, while Drag Race Philippines Season 1 third-place finisher Eva the Queen will be part of the inaugural Drag Race Global All-Stars, which debuts later this month. Many of them look forward to reuniting for the next DragCon taking place in January in the UK. And fans of the hit Philippine girl group Beanie created a frenzy in Edmonton with a sold-out concert. The city was electrified with excitement as fans lined up hours before the show, some traveling from as far as Manitoba, Saskatchewan, Calgary, and Vancouver.
I really like Beanie because their personalities are not only relatable, but their artistry is really good. I believe that their talent and their skills in hard work are able to expand the beauty of Filipino music to the public.
The Expo Center was electric as fans sang along to Beanie's hit songs, creating a powerful chorus that echoed through the venue. For many, this was a dream come true, celebrating not just the performance, but Filipino culture.
We just feel so grateful to represent P-pop and to show everyone that this is the Pinoy talent.
As the night ended with a heartfelt encore, fans were reminded to keep an eye out for Beanie's continued Canadian tour in Winnipeg and Toronto this weekend.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manato. Back to our friends at The Rundown.
Russia releases footage of civilians evacuating from two districts in the Kursk region near the border with Ukraine. Moscow has evacuated nearly 200,000 people after Ukrainian forces smashed through the border last week in a surprise attack and carved out a slice of Russian territory. Kyiv says it is creating a security zone and plans to organize humanitarian assistance and evacuation corridors for civilians looking to go either to Russia or Ukraine. In his nightly address. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky hailed the good advance in Kursk and says Kyiv was achieving its strategic goal in the operation. He also again appealed to Western partners to allow long-range strikes on targets inside Russia. The World Health Organization declares Mpox a global public health emergency for the second time in 2 years. This following an outbreak of the viral infection in the Democratic Republic of Congo that has spread to neighboring countries. The outbreak began with the spread of the endemic strain, but a new variant has emerged which spreads more easily through close contact.
It's clear that a coordinated international response is essential to stop these outbreaks and save lives. A public health emergency of international concern is the highest level of alarm under international health law.
More than 17,000 suspected Mpox cases and 517 deaths have been reported on the African continent so far this year. That's 160% increase over the same period last year.